Today's movie tells the story of the smartest doorman in the world, Tom Labreck. And when he was studying, he was able to come up with a plan and solve the problem of Mexican gas leakage in the largest gas companies in the world, competing to hire him with them before he even graduated. Who are they? Those who offer him a position as an executive director, and some of them offer him shares in the company, and some of them also offer him directly that he receive a quarter of $1,000 US a year, but Tom refuses all these offers, and despite all the amazing opportunities that were presented to him, Tom decides that he travels to Spain to offer a specific job from one of his names, and this wazifa needs Tom to use his sacat and penetrate a basement inside which something Walter wants, and this basement is very special, and they consider it an engineering miracle for more than 80 years. And then he meets Tom and introduces him to the team that will work with him, and we learn that the owner of an extraction company, and how many months ago he had valuable antiques in a ship that sank in the sea in Spain. Among the things he threw were valuable and very expensive currencies, but unfortunately the mission failed, and the Spanish authorities exported everything they found. And now all these things are stored in this distinguished basement in a Spanish bank, and we get to know one of the team members. Her name is Lorraine, and she is a girl adoption, and a role in the team is the facilitator, so that she can play any role the team needs in the missions they carry out. The third member is a mogul named Claus, who remains responsible for the team's needs in hacking devices, and the fourth member is James Musid, Walter's right assistant, and since he is a former soldier, he is also the strongest one in the team, and the fifth and last individual is responsible for purchasing tools and logistics for the team, and as long as there is no money available, he will answer anything the team needs. And on the day that Tom arrives, the team will not be able to hack the bank's belt, because they need a code to enter into the belt. But it will take time, and they do not have much time, so they missed proposing a simple solution to their problem, and he tells them to call one of the bank's clients as if they were an audio recording, he said to me, and this movement makes them reach the codes they need from the customer, and after they try it, the team gets the code they needed, and on his second day with the team, Tom studies the official plan of the Bank of Spain, and this bank is considered the strongest bank built fortified on the planet, especially since it is full of sensors that measure sensitivity, and cameras in every inch, and there are also trained guards that they act immediately in any problem that may happen. And the biggest problem in front of them now is that the team he finds the way to cross the street without cameras capturing them, nor the headquarters of the Spanish army, which is located in the face of the bank, and when the bank bell rings, about 5,000 soldiers run over there to deal with the problem, and above all, the bank guard is the former major Spanish anti-terrorism forces, and so a team will be facing a force capable of dealing with any type of attack on the bank, and the team will have little information about the basement in the bank, and in order to know more information about the internal structure of the basement, they still need to make a swab to plan it. And currently all they know is that they will need two keys to the basement and the fingerprints of the bank's guard official, so the team is conducting an operation. They prepare everything they need for the big mission, and Tom and Simon enter the bank as cleaners, and on the other side, she claims that she is an insurance agent for famous paintings, and in the bank offices, the paintings remain on the safes in which they carry the keys they need for the basement. She meets the bank guard on her way, and she is going to see these paintings, and she asks him to hold her cup of coffee so that she can greet the bank manager, and in this way she can take his fingerprints and what we need for the basement. And in the office of the first painting, he helps Lauren deal with the bank's surveillance cameras, and they record a video of Lorraine making a smear of these plates, and they put them at a speed of 10% of the real speed, to show that nothing strange is happening to her. Lauren finds the safe, gets her kit ready, and starts copying the key, and after she copies, an unexpected guest comes and causes her problems. She has 20 years ahead of her, before she deceived the camera that placed her to stop, and she needs to be in the same place in order to complete the video normally without problems. But the bank manager is in the camera, and Lorraine needs him to stay away from the scene in front of the camera, so she asks him to take a picture of her, while she is smearing the painting, and asks him to go back to Laura's steps while he is filming her, and at the last moment she is able to push him away. It appears in the camera and the video that it ends, and then it goes to look for the second key, but on the other side, it faces a problem, and its task is to clear the basement installation, and in order to do that, Tom makes himself a cleaner and goes to the ground floor of the bank. It is assumed that this basement is located under one of the meeting rooms in this floor. When one wakes up, the meeting table is opened and the magnetometer is turned on in order to start the scanning process, but suddenly a group of officials enters. They do an interview, and Tom is locked under a table. They also find that the device starts to malfunction, and the swab process stops at 96%. After the device is repaired, it comes back to work, and the scanning continues. Unfortunately, this makes the alarm device work in the bank. And the whole bank is closed under the management of the bank's guard, and the army forces come running, and at this time Lauren still has copies of the second copy of the basement key, and here the manager comes to take it and because of her urgency, Lauren is unable to return the key that she stole and locks the safe in which he was paralyzed. The team decides in the end that Lauren throws the key to Tom so that he can return it, and after Tom takes the key, he runs to the third floor and returns the key and locks the safe, and the first time he locks the safe they alert Tom that a female bodyguard is coming to him quickly, so Tom is thinking of a very clever plan to escape with. When the female guard enters, she asks him what he is doing here. She is doing it himself. He put the headphone on and played songs, and that's why he didn't hear the alarm and ran away from the situation and didn't get arrested because of his quick thinking and the brave move he made. After the operation is over, Tom begins to analyze the internal structure of the basement and finds a certain part of the survey that is not clearly occupied, so he realizes that this part is water and that the seal is designed based on a weighing device. And when the basement opens, any change in weight will make the basement close and the place will fill up with water. Now the team knows how to operate the basement, and they face a problem, which is that they motivate the weight to hibernate, and Tom begins to think about how he can solve this problem, and he works all the time at this time. They discover a huge discovery when they search the area under the bank, and they know that Tom was right, which is that there is a huge weighing device under the bank, and the current weight is zero. And here they encounter a big problem that makes them cancel all their plans. And it is that the walls of the underground room are very strong, especially since they are made of titanium iron and reinforced concrete. I mean, from the end, they will take about 15 days to reach the precaution, even if they used the most powerful drill in the world, they would not be able to storm the place of course, they do not have all this time, because they have a short period of time to finish this theft operation, and thus they conclude that the operation is impossible to complete, and the team is thinking to divert a little from the topic, and Walter is thinking of a way, and at the same time he is watching football fans while they are in the field at the same time. We notice that at the time of the World Cup finals, all the cameras in the bank will remain focused on the fans in the field, and this means that they will not have to enter the bank from underground, and they can enter from the roof easily, so he tells the team and they make a change in the plan, and everyone returns with hope. Everyone depends on Tom and his ability to think, and how he can deal with the basement mechanic, and after he goes to a break with Lorraine in a bar near them, Tom finally discovers a way to deal with the basement safety mechanism. He explains the solution to them while placing a cup of water in front of them on a weighing device. Those who show them the movement of the scale, then take out the cup, sprinkle liquid nitrogen on the device, and return to put the cup on it. This time, the device does not measure the weight of the cup, nor does it move because he remains frozen. He tells them that the same idea can be triggered by the huge measuring device in the basement. The only problem they have now is that they will need a large amount of liquid nitrogen to trigger the process after they prepare the plan. The team begins the operation, and the football match between Spain and the Netherlands begins, and the team has 105 minutes in front of them, just to carry out the operation, and they attach a rope to the roof of the bank building, move on it, and cut a hole in the suture. And they enter the bank through this hole, and after that they walk through about a meter of pipes until they reach the entrance to the room in which there is a basement, and there they run on the stairs, and finally they reach in front of the basement, and Claus begins to break through the belt of the bank in order to enter the team, and they use the two keys and the fingerprints that they got, and finally they find themselves in front of the basement. And here comes Simon's role in the operation, and he starts spraying liquid nitrogen on the scale to freeze it, and after all the liquid he has is finished with, the plan succeeds and the floor of the basement freezes after that. The team enters the basement and starts searching for the box that contains the coins they are looking for. At this time, the bank patrol team discovers the roof hatch and runs to the basement and Lorraine finds the coins, but they don't expect what will happen next and come out. A scheme betrays the team from the beginning, and we discover that he is a secret agent, and now he plans to steal coins from the team, and Lauren is forced to give James the coins, and at this time, the liquid nitrogen freeze cap begins to disappear, and the basement safety mechanism works. And now Tom, James and Lorraine are locked inside, and water enters from everywhere in the basement, and James, since he is a former soldier, is used to this circumstance, and he floats and gets out of the trap, and that's how he escapes with the coins, and now the lives of Tom and Lauren are in real danger, and the rest of the team can't do anything for them to help them, and they're about to drown. He starts the drainage process, so Simon moves the nitrogen tubes and puts them all on the scale, and after he puts them all in and goes out with them to reach the weight is still not enough, and after he gives up, he looks at his radio and he decides to put it with him on the scale, and for good luck, his idea will succeed. And who knew that this radio is the one who will save them and make the water stop entering inside and start the exchange process, and at this time the guard official and his men will be on their way to the basement. When they open it, they don't find anyone inside, and we discover that Tom and Lorraine escaped from the sewage pipes to escape from there and go out to the ground, and the bank security force chases them, and they don't have time with them, and here Lorraine thinks that the room she entered is scanning the manager's plates. They leave the window open, so they run over there immediately. And then Tom Mulloran escapes from the bank and joins the football fans who are in the field, taking off their jackets, and we meet them wearing football undershirts. And they mix with the crowd, but despite all their efforts, the soldiers catch them, and they will catch them, so Tom and Lorraine realize that they are finished, and they accept their fate, but fate has other plans for them, and at this moment Spain wins the match and this makes the fans go crazy and jump everywhere, and this hinders the movement of the soldiers, and Tom Mulloran takes advantage of the opportunity and flees him. And after a few days, James returns the coins to his manager, and they decipher the code on them, and they discover that the original coins are in the Eiffel Tower. They realize that the Wilters team deceived them, and it turns out that Lauren changed the coins in the basement, and James took the fake coins. The team relaxes with Tom in a resort in France, and they discover the correct assumptions about the treasure they are looking for, and the team discovers that the treasure is in the Bank of England this time, and from here the team starts working again and puts a new plan, and this is how it ends.